In this video, I'm going to show you the best play that you can utilize out of the gun bunch offense to absolutely destroy the meta defense, which is a 30-yard cloud flat out of a Tampa 2 shell. Now, if you're new to the channel, be sure to subscribe. I upload new videos every single day that can help you become a better Madden player. And guys, I also wanted to let you know that if you want to get my entire bunch ebook, I'm going to put a link to that in the description below. Bunch has been one of the best offenses Madden for pretty much as long as I've been playing. I wrote my first gun bunch ebook back in 2012 in Madden 12, and since then it has been probably one of the most successful offenses year in and year out. The routes, the combinations, the concepts, the pass protection, all of that make it one of the best offenses in the game. However, one of the major drawbacks to Bunch can be the fact that if you are playing 30-yard cloud flats, it is a little bit difficult sometimes to get over the top of that. Well, in this video, we're going to give you an answer to that problem. And it comes to us out of the Seattle Seahawks playbook. However, you can find this play in a lot of different gun bunches. What I'm going to simply do is come out in the $326. And you are going to see that I'm going to be running a cover two kind of base coverage to show this. Now, like I said, we are in the Seattle Seahawks offensive playbook. The play that we are going to be coming out in, this is something that also I was going to quickly point this out. I was watching some film and I saw that Skimbo has actually been utilizing this. I think that he had mentioned that he labbed this to get over 30-yard clouds as well. This is one of his go-to plays for that situation. And he actually ran it in the last MCS tournament to be able to get over the top of 30-yard cloud flat that one of my other guys that I really like to study spam and buttons was running. And so just wanted to kind of break down that concept. I've been talking about it for a while. I want to show you a way that I really like to run this mesh post. I'm gonna give you two setups today that are really, really good, and we're just gonna jump right in. So the beauty of mesh post is, as you can see here, my bunch is to the wide side of the field. Okay, what we're gonna show you is two ways to run this. So the first way to run this, so you see here, just a basic cover two Mabel setup is what we're seeing. If my play art is glitched, but you see it works, okay? So now what we're going to do is we are going, the only hot routes we really require here is I like to go ahead and streak Mike Evans. I'd like to block my tight end, and then I'm going to put my running back on a in route. So you see here we have a little mesh concept over the middle of the field, and then we have this deep post that if you look at it really closely, it's a special type of post. It's not a sharp cutting post, it's the angled post, and the real trick of this is to get this post to keep running. There's certain situations where this post will stop running, and that's why when you run to the short side, oftentimes it does help it. You can also run this to the wide side. When you run it out of a compression set, it significantly helps the route because you don't get those same issues. So anyways, here's mesh post. Just want to show you. So I've got my clouds on 30. You see that streak's going to clear out that vertical, and then I can pass lead that up. And as you can see on the sideline, I'm going to get a really great catch from Antonio Brown. Again, Antonio Brown has no abilities, no significant ratings that we really need to talk about, but yet he's still able to get over the top of these 30-yard cloud flats. And the cool part about this is my bunch, right, my bunch set was to the wide side of the field. To me, that's huge. I can run the short side or wide side, and I'll show you what I'm talking about in this next portion. We're going to run the same thing, but I'm going to flip my bunch. So you see, I'm going to flip my bunch, and now I'm going to run mesh post to the wide side of the field. Now, if you're going to run this in Mutt and you can control it, I would highly recommend the ability Deep Out Elite on the player that is running this route. The reason why that ability is so powerful is because of the way that it works in a situation where you have a sideline catch animation. You get really good animations out of the Deep Out Elite ability. So you see here the same exact setup, but this time we're going to run it to the wide side of the field. And I want you to watch how this play works. We run this to the wide side of the field. As you can see, the post is going to stop running, and that's really, really important to point out. So sometimes, now again, I'm in a red zone situation, it's a little bit different, but sometimes that post will stop running if you run it to from the short side of the field to the wide side of the field. So if our bunch is to the short side of the field and we're trying to run that post, you will see that that sometimes does happen. The reason that I wanted to point that out is because to me, it suggests that I think it's much more strategic to run that post from the wide side of the field to the short side of the field. There are other situations. If you smart route the post, there's some other variables that I didn't talk about. But in general, my recommendation would be to run the post from the wide side to the short side. Okay. Now, the last way that I wanted to break this down is I wanted to give you a way that you could run this where you have a max protect. A max protect setup is where you're able to essentially block seven, and you're going to be able to still get routes open regardless of the type of defense that they're going to play. So to illustrate this, we're going to go into the gun bunch again, and we're going to go back to mesh post. And then on defense, we're going to go back to that $326 max coverage out of the cover two drop. And what we'll show you here, and this is something that, again, because the whole art of this is like, we want to hold the user, okay? We want to hold their user. So what I like to do with this is we're just going to max protect. So you see, we're going to block our running back. We're going to block our tight end. And then this is something that Skimbo does that I think is, or I don't know that Skimbo does it this year, but he used to do this, and I thought it was super strategic. But he did it in a little bit of a different way, but the basic concept is essentially the same. So what we're going to do here is we're actually going to motion Godwin to the right, and I'm going to put him on a seam streak. The reason that I like this seam streak is because what I can do with this now is now I have a quick hitter. And also, if you watch the cover two drop, any deep coverage, they're going to suck into the middle of the field. So it's going to leave a much more open area where we can hit the sideline. The other thing that we have is a simple check down to Mike Evans. When you have a drag coming across the formation and you have that post going over the top, if the play breaks down, I can always playmaker the drag. I can playmaker it upfield, up in the middle of the field. So what you're going to see here, the drag goes across. You see everything gets sucked into the middle. The cloud flat sucks down. And as you can see, I can hit that post on the sideline, even against a 30-yard cloud. The other thing that I want to just quickly point out about this concept is you can, and again, if you want to leave the outside streak, you certainly can. You can run a motion drag. You can run a motion slant if you want to run the slant. But why I like this so much is because if I'm in a situation, you know, like this, it's a real quick, you know, hot route a streak, motion them over, and you're good. The setup is done. But what we can do off of this is if you look to this right side here, now if they're not playing hard flats, now I've got a window to hit that all across the field. They have to have two yellows, two hard flats to be able to stop a drag consistently. Now, if you wanted to turn that into a simple five-yard dig, that's also another great way to do this. Let me give you another example of what you could do. So I could take Godwin here. And again, it's just one hot route. That's one thing that I really like about this. It's just simply one hot route, and then I can motion this guy over and go. And what you'll see is this drag. See how I can throw it here, I can throw it here, I can throw it here, and then I can throw it all the way across the formation just like that. So the drag allows you to have a really, really good check down. I want to take one more sack, and I want to show you one other thing that you can do with this drag that really does make this play one of the more difficult plays to stop in the entire game based off of the way that most people are generally playing the gun bunch. So let me show you that. I just took a quick sack there, and then now I want to show you this concept. So what we can do in this situation is, again, if we have time in the pocket, and to illustrate this, we'll just drop these guys in coverage. But what you're going to see is if I wait on this right about here, I can playmaker. Watch that square. See how he goes up into an area of the field? And again, I throw a pick. But you see the idea. I can playmaker that in a different direction. If you have the playmaker ability, you could playmaker him back on that drag. There's a lot of benefit to that concept. So I just wanted to kind of point out that you can do that. So that's the beauty of this play, is it gives you, it's a max protection. You have good pass, protection. And then it's something that I can do. You get that 30-yard cloud beater. It's going to beat every coverage in the game. That post has to be used. And then you have the drag as a basic check down. And I just feel like this is probably one of the best plays in the game that not very many people really utilize out of the gun bunch. So if you are running gun bunch, you want to learn how I run gun bunch, I actually compiled a lot of different things in our gun bunch ebook. It's not just Seattle bunch. It's actually pretty much the gun bunch period. And then we break down every single playbook, concept from multiple different playbooks. So you get some stuff from Carolina, you get some stuff from Seattle, you get some stuff. All of the stuff is together in one cohesive guide. So the cool part about our Patreon membership is by signing up for just $10 a month, you get instant access to every ebook. We've released 13 ebooks so far this year. Bunch is just one of those ebooks. We've also got a Bunch Tight End ebook. We've got a Trips Tight End ebook. We got a ton of guides over there. So if you want to sign up for my Patreon, We've got 8 defensive guides as well. You can click the link in the description below. I'm going to put a link in the description, and you just click that Patreon link. It'll take you right over. You'll get signed up. It's literally just $10 a month, and you can cancel whenever you want. So it's just a great deal in my personal opinion, and I'd really encourage you, if you really want to take your Madden game to the next level, join the Patreon. I guarantee you it'll get you a lot better at this game. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you guys next time.